My biggest challenge so far has probably been some of the personalities that I've had to work with. But I think actually it's been mainly the travel actually that's the thing that I really struggle with, you know, constantly up and down. It can kind of eat up a lot of your time without you thinking about it. But other than that, it's no bad. My advice for other young leaders would be, first of all, to make sure you have confidence in yourself. And some people often mistake arrogance for confidence. And I always say that the way you tell the difference is that confidence comes naturally when you can say, do you know what, I've done a lot of homework on this, or I've looked really hard at this and I've thought about this harder than most other people have. So in that instance, I would say that you just have to believe in your own abilities and to keep working at it. First and foremost, I'd say the ability to criticise yourself. I think that the best and biggest leaders in any walk of life are people who surround themselves with folk who are quite often better than they are and actually challenge them a lot. And I think that's definitely the most important thing. First of all, get organised. The difference it makes when you actually plan out what you're doing with your week. And I know it sounds like a really simple one, but you'll be amazed at how many people don't do it. In particular, when it's to do with health and social care, I think that's more than just about a university doing well. That's about how our society is going to function and the things that students are taught in these classes and at facilities like this. That underpins everything that they do for the rest of their life. Probably my mum, which is a really cheesy answer, but that's one leader that I don't think anyone could defeat. She's just always been, you know, resolute. She's been constantly compassionate, but always really firm. You know, she doesn't suffer fools, as she puts it, and I think that that's key to having actually a good functioning government from my point of view. So I've always looked to my mum for a bit of inspiration. She's always given it.